Welcome to the STABcast, a podcast dedicated to Star Wars Legion.
I have brought peace, freedom, justice, and security to my new empire.
Your new empire?
Don't make me kill you.
Anakin, my allegiance is to the Republic, to democracy!
If you're not with me, then you're my enemy.
Only a Sith deals in absolutes. I will do what I must.
You will try.
Welcome, cadets and commanders, to the STABcast, the SunSphere Tactical Attack Brigade's Star Wars Legion podcast, because we took that out of our intro
there
for some
is.
Reason. I am Ryan. At last, we will reveal ourselves to the Jedi. At last, we will have our revenge, Slowoski. With Will, Tatooine is a sparsely populated. If the homing trace is correct, I will find them quickly, Master. Heim, Tim, yes, Master Hannon. Also with Ben, we ran out of Maul dialogue because he only has three lines, Fowler. How's everybody doing?
You know, the man got robbed. To play Maul, I feel like I should have had all the lines.
No, that's why you get nothing.
You can have all the lines from the first time he shows up in Clone Wars and just screams.
I get all the lines from Clone Wars.
Kenobi.
And
it's
from,
just
you know,
saying
Rebels.
Kenobi.
I get all the good lines.
Yeah, he's just screaming Kenobi, which you is
you
should have
been Ben Kenobi Fowler.
Which, listen, if you've listened to my rants over the past, I don't know, 100 episodes, I definitely do say Kenobi a lot in those.
That's what I'm saying. It's appropriate.
It's appropriate.
I'm Kenobi! Just saying it was my turn to do the intro, and you get a piece of Maul dialogue if you play the game of Star Wars Legion.
You get what you pay for.
Wow. I played in the last month.
Then he got you.
Listen.
Such a skillful
I'm actually
kind of
impressed you added that piece back in, because I was going to put it in there. I was like, no, they're just going to complain if I put what the SunSphere Tactical Attack Brigade is. So I did not write that for you today.
I did it. I remembered what our show is called and named after. Look at me go.
Oh, nice.
I remember.
I know. You hit that on the first ride, too. I was kind of actually impressed. This week on the STABcast, the news, of course, came out right after we published the last episode. And some
battle
reports.
They know.
And, you know, whatever other fun things come our way. So, speaking of fun things, I didn't play any games, as you've already heard in this podcast. You know, work, guys. I'm trying. I get this graduate degree. Things are much better for a tiny bit until I possibly go back for that doctorate.
It's good
but
that we're letting you
stuff.
Get this out of the way early.
I know.
So it can
exactly.
be done with.
So we don't have to, yeah. So, mostly, my battle reports are imaginary and delicious, and mostly, I end up winning them. Not always, but mostly.
You still lose to bread in your dreams.
Yeah, you do lose to bread in your dreams. Nightmares, really.
Goddamn Chattanooga trash can. So, Ryan, how was your game?
So, yeah, this week, you know, I've been trying to get out more and more frequently. We'll see how that long it lasts with COVID back on the rise. But I went out, and we actually had a pretty small number of players at the store. We had the grand total of three. It was myself. I ran by Will's place, picked up a table of terrain, and went on down to Sci-Fi City to play Brandon. One of our local staples, and he brought Patrick, who Ben gave a bat report on last week. He was our WWE-style announcer who sat at the end of the table and
nice.
And observed and made sure that most of our cheating was at least cheating within the confines of the rules. And I wanted I wanted to get Han back on the table. I am hoping and I am praying that point changes are coming, and since I haven't put Han or Chewie on the table, I wanted to get them back out because they're the models that I want to see like really impacted by whatever errata happens to come, and I wanted to be sure that I could fully appreciate it when it comes, and so when it doesn't come, I'm going to be really disappointed. You can edit that any way
right,
you really
right.
want to.
I'm not going to.
Okay. And... so I brought double teamwork. I brought Han, Cassian, Chewie, K2. And the other wrinkle of surprise in the list was I didn't bring change of plans. Instead, I brought sacrifice because I figured K2 trying to help keep Han alive would be pretty cool, both with reckless diversion onto K2 and then just giving K2 guardian for a turn to kind of hang out near him. And then Brandon brought a... Rex, R2, Padme, triple arc. I think it was one phase two and four phase ones, and I think they all but one of them had Z6s. So it was just a bucket of dice brigade of a clone list. I rounded my 800 points out with some rebel troopers, two medics, a sniper, and a set of Mandalorian resistance with the Beskar duelist.
So on behalf of clone players everywhere, you deserve it.
So, you know, honestly, the faction I was most worried about, because Brandon does play all four, is I was actually more worried about droids of all things, because I don't have a great answer for a big, beefy melee fighter outside of the Mandos, but they're only going to keep Grievous at bay for so long. And then Han is really good against red saves.
Yeah.
So, you know, I got a lot of Pierce in my list, so I wasn't too heartbroken to see clones. But we played on this cool lava table with towers and walkways that I set up between pieces of terrains as like some catwalks, so you could move both above and under them, which was cool. I thought the table was pretty rad. Through our turns.
Going back to last week's episode, we talked about how you can remodulate your tables, mm-hmm. and that's a sign you've got really good pieces.
Yeah.
And so that's what this is. Our Mustafar table set rearranged very nicely. I actually like the pictures.
So we do our battle cards, and we ended up with sabotage, supply drop, and advanced positions. I was a little hesitant on supply drop, but I was like, you know what? I'm running four rebel heroes. They can make some pretty good use of these boxes. Let's see what we can't get done. I think I got a pretty solid table edge to achieve what I want to achieve. I can kind of hide both my evaporators, and the one that's definitely more open than the other, I can just forward deploy Cassian onto really, really easy. Tap it and run away. So that was a lot of fun. I will say supply drop on sabotage is kind of boring, because you just put boxes right next to evaporators and we just see what happens. Mm-hmm. And then two other boxes.
I'm surprised you went with sabotage with supply drop, mostly because when ARC troopers, you know, tactical one forward, they get a supply drop and an aim token movement, and then they shoot you in the face with whatever they just picked up.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
So he chose sabotage because it was sitting, I think, on recover, which obviously I'm more than willing to play.
The sweet boxes.
And I picked supply drop because my other alternative was hostile. And with him being up an activation on me, plus having fives and Padme, I knew that that I would hopefully get more to keep Han alive than he would. And everything went as it should, and we both got all of our boxes. We didn't do any weird box trading. But with advanced positions and Rex and the Rex Star, man, he just took we had like a shield generator set up in the middle of the table, and honestly, like half the table didn't even get used. We had a big fight down upon around a big line of sight blocker that I was trying to use to give Han some cover as he made his short range approach, Han and Chewie. And K2 ran across the catwalk to try to go join them from where Cassian forward deployed. And I kind of put my Mandos out on an edge by themselves, and their whole job was to be a distraction first and foremost, but also if they can get through to run where the immobile clone ball can't quite get them, and just tag his back vap once, so he has to commit a little more back there. But he put R2 in one of his phase ones with a Z6 back there to kind of guard it. And his first move was to scout with the scouting party with Rex, and then play the Extendo Mags card, and just did a huge fire support with a sniper rifle and I want to say his phase twos with Z6 and fives into my Mandos, putting them on one model first activation.
Bleh.
Yeah.
Bleh.
So it was
what a horrible and obscene thing that someone can do in Legion.
Yeah. It feels pretty bad.
Shame on them.
But
how dare they have that kind of power?
To Eric Andre, this, why did you make him shoot you?
Yeah,
I can't believe
why did
done
you
this?
Invite this upon yourself.
We
you made him do this.
He had a little bunker that he put Padme in where I could never get line of sight on her, so that was kind of irritating, but it had a window to where he Mad could see his troopers to pass them their tokens. R2 didn't make his secret mission just because we ran out of time, But it did go down 4-4, as you would expect. I was pressuring the VAP, but I could never have enough actions to hit his VAP and to get to it and hit it in the same turn. Han and Chewie got into skirmish range, but due to a mistake on my part, I thought Chewie was engaging a set of two ARC troopers in melee when it was just one, and when he triggered charge, he killed the ARC trooper, and there was a less likelihood of him killing the group of two, which I thought I was engaging. That wasn't the end of the world. Han had an incredible defense rolls. Like, I kind of wish Tim was here to see this, where I want to say Han got nine hits thrown into him, dodged two away, and then through some good rolls and then even better uncanny luck, I think I took two wounds out of nine. You know, two dodge tokens.
You lost the right to complain.
Yeah, sure. But it came down, at the end of the day, did come down to points destroyed. But the problem with the clone problem is despite all the Pierce I had, I really couldn't use it because it's so range limited when I'm charging a sniper line of three arcs that are getting fire support.
Yep.
With my white saves, I just didn't have the wounds. If I would have had Leia in my army, that would have helped probably instead of Cassian, pushing some troopers up with No Times for Sorrows. I thought about halfway through the game could have really been a huge difference maker. I played Sacrifice a turn too early, where I wanted to move K2 up to get to range 2 of Han as my first activation, but when I really probably should have saved it for a turn where he was already there, because it meant I had to activate K2 first, which meant he got an activation to just pump Han full of holes.
Right.
But I will say, it is a combo I want to try again, maybe not with Chewie. But Reckless Diversion on K2 is hilarious, and I honestly think it's the card interaction that got me back into the game. While my Mandos did okay on defense, they rolled, I think, about where they're supposed to. K2SO did not roll anything but blocks all game, and he probably shrugged off between defense dice and armor and cover probably 15 wounds. It was pretty wild. But Brandon held the line, got a lot more activations off the table, clone balled up and took the game. I think we played four turns before the Ruthless Jonathan threw us out of the store. But it was a good game. It was a close game. I felt pretty good about getting as close as I did with the list I was playing versus what I had to go up against. But it was fun. I had a good time. Now fix Han, please.
Well, I'm sorry you had to play such a horrible faction. You know, the clones are just such a, you know, annoying thing to play against.
Yep.
But, you know, Tim and I played recently.
Yep.
We did. It was such a good time, and it was a fun time, and much fun was had. Moving on.
Now, Tim, I made an Instagram post about it and everything. We have to tell them about what happened.
I saw with your gorgeous Obi-Wan.
He is beautiful. He's an angel.
His flowing and locks.
My poor Bosk.
He's there in the photo.
Mabosk.
Mabosk. And then there's your stormtrooper that's doing a kick because you just glued him that way. Listen, it's a great time.
He's great. It's fantastic. And
that's before he got, sliced in half by...
Will, that's a spoiler. Perhaps. We're not there yet. Will, what was your list?
Ah, well, I brought Obi-Wan.
All right, there you go.
Obi-Wan with push and barrier, which we'll talk about.
As you do.
And then he also had situational, and I think no command this game is what I tried to do. I have the list up here. Yeah, no command. Then I had R2-3PO, Padme with strict, and then a bunch of clones. Two phase twos with Z6s and situational, two phase ones with nothing, a full arc team with fives, and then an arc strike team with Echo.
Okay. Why have you done
it's
this?
It's a very good list. It's very good.
No, thank you.
It's very good.
No, thank you, please. No, thank you.
It doesn't have Rex, so I have a little moral high ground, which is necessary with Obi-Wan.
No, you don't have the moral high ground.
You have Padme and the robot.
It's a millimeter, but I have it. Tim, what did you bring?
You're the lone rat from the sewer that stands slightly above the muck.
Tim, what did you bring with your not overpowered faction?
Oh. that's sad.
It's so true. Join me in the bottom of the barrel here, buddy. It's fine.
Well, we're not that bad, but yeah.
There's some platforms in the barrel.
Yeah, it's okay. We had a couple little steps. I had an interesting take, and this was made to kind of try and counter my essay frustration. It was not made for clones per se, but it doesn't hurt against clones. I think it actually would have hurt against droids, if anything, but it was my buddy Palp with barrier and anger. And then
we're Bosk, both trying out barrier.
Yes. Bosk with his long range attacks of doom, with also Hunter and targeting scopes. Couldn't think of the
word. That's one.
Aiden with, and this is blasphemy for me, I know. Aiden with her sniper config. No,
that's two.
No buddy bot, just a sniper. Triple snipers. Just kidding.
That's five.
That's five. That's five. Triple snipers. And then Del Miko in a snow squad for six snipers, basically.
Six snipers, everyone.
Plus, I had two naked storm squads.
Yes, you did.
Yes, and those are my two objective boys that actually did okay. But
they did.
I'm glad to hear we got the named ones inside the snow troopers. We've been talking about it for a couple of months now, so I'm glad to see it.
I was expecting the Gideon, and I got the Del instead.
Yes, because I want, you know what's better than some snipers? All the snipers.
Right.
And then also,
with the Palpatine, he's getting seven sniper-ish shots a turn. Yep,
seven snipers.
It was something.
Listen, I would like to just take this moment to remark that we nearly did a dude, you're getting a Del joke, which we had to explain to Will 15 episodes ago.
Oh, so we did that joke.
That hurts. Yeah, you did.
It was in the episode.
It was in the episode. So nice callback, Will. Nice callback.
Yeah. And also, I didn't have Hunter on her as well to help out with that. But yeah.
I mean, yeah.
Dude, and you're killing Adele.
All the
not Adele.
Not Adele. She's Lizzo rolling is better. Crits. But yes, all the snipers. And it was interesting. I wanted to see again the effectiveness of a pull the string snipers kind of list against.
Now, listener, you might know by SA. Now that Tim's safety word is interesting for when things go poorly.
That's right.
You're not wrong. It was interesting.
We ended up playing Sabotage and Supply Drop.
Yep.
But we were on the hemmed in map, and I was the blue player.
Mm-hmm.
So Tim dropped his entire, I don't know, maybe 20 models in one side of hemmed in.
That's right. They all went in one spot.
I don't even, it might have been 20. It might have been less than that.
You keep going. I'll think about it.
Yeah, keep doing some math. I was kind of in a bad spot because I didn't have a ton of terrain going on that was, I had a lot of light cover, which Tim brought seven sniper shots that ignore light cover.
It should be 22 models. 22 models.
22. Okay. Yes. Okay.
Yes.
That's nearly a clone list. Well, I had more than you, which was weird. Like I had like 28. But
you guys are broken.
I basically had to take the first two turns and run because I was just getting taken like pot shots at by all of Tim's army.
They were more than pot shots. I was doing great.
Yeah, normally it's like, oh no, a clone. But then that happened seven times, and instead of clones, it was all of Padme.
Yeah. Yes, Padme didn't make it. Padme didn't make it past round one because it was everybody's shooter. Well, we were shooting Obi-Wan at first, and then he hit Obi-Wan behind the coffee can of safety, which really saved his ass. But
yes,
anyway,
there was one coffee can in the middle. That was the lone line of sight blocker that I could get to, and I was like, everyone behind that can.
Yes.
So Obi-Wan ran up, and all the clones ran up, and Padme was just a little behind and got sniped.
She didn't make
to death.
So as the the trash can man from Chattanooga would say, you have a moral victory right there, Tim. You eliminated Padme at the very first round.
Exactly.
Except that he left the really dangerous one alive.
I tried to kill him, but then he hid.
He did. He hid just long enough.
God.
He bided his time.
So he ended up jumping up. What turn is this? I don't know. I've lost track at this point.
Turn one, Padme died.
Right.
Let's say that.
Turn one, Padme died.
Turn two, I'm still behind the can. Turn three, I pop up.
Yes. And then, of course, at this point, throughout the whole game, it should be, of course, be noted, because in case the listeners haven't heard, there's a newsflash that says you can pay 35 points to win the game. So,
yes. So Will R2 chose... slowly making his way towards the side of Hemdim that Tim yes. put no units in.
Will chose...
make his way downtown?
I couldn't really put any units there, but yes. I mean, I could have put Sniper Aiden. Sniper Aiden would have gotten bunked. But anyway, so yes, and then they just continue to march forward to the victory point, and that's fine. Well, just keep yes. that in the back of your head, listeners, that you can pay 35 points to win the game.
Each time we mention around, just imagine a double move towards the deployment zone by R2.
Right, and all my snipers watching him go saying, we could shoot him, but because we can shoot someone else, we only get one shot. And of course, one sniper shot's not going to be enough to kill him. So,
oh no, a wound.
You know, yeah, a wound. Hooray,
because and then no course, one else can shoot you know, the Imperial sniper rolls one blank, because of yeah. course it does. Or it's a yes. surge, and you just have to stare at it.
Yeah. It was.
Or it's Dell, and the light cover still counts, because, you know.
Yes. Now, he's not as good as the other.
So let's fast forward a little bit here to where we're starting to get a little bit more into the nitty-gritty of it.
How dare
boss,
you.
Boss starts getting shot at, and that's a little dicey for me. And this is where Barrier comes in, and I loved Barrier for Boss.
I did, too.
It's so good.
For the record.
Because I don't have to roll these white saves that just kind of blank out all the time. Because, yeah, he blanked some saves, but he would have been dead, like, probably a round before. Except Palp just neutered two of those hits.
I had basically all my surviving clones that could get behind the can got there.
Correct.
And then I would token up and have one phase two, like, pop out and just try to blast something. It was my only real way of affecting Tim without just losing four or five clones per round. And then I don't have that many clones. So I popped out and shot Bossk in heavy cover because I don't have to care about heavy cover most of the time.
Right.
And
gross.
I got like...
Yeah, that's right. He said it.
I got like 9 hits off of a Z6 squad's 10 yep, dice.
As you do.
So heavy as cover made it... Heavy cover made it 7, and then Barrier made it 5, and then Bossk blanked it all because yep. he does that.
Yep.
Well, because you threw 42 dice at him.
Yeah. I threw 10 dice.
And got 9 of the 10.
Because nine I had of the 10. Because I had 4 aims and like 3 surges, yeah.
Yeah. It's bad. It's bad. It's real bad.
This is how it works, Ben. I can't keep apologizing.
And then here's the other thing.
You now, can and you should.
Listeners, you might think, huh, who's the bounty on? It was on Obi-Wan, because I didn't expect Padme to stay out there and die. And also, Boss wouldn't have been the one to kill Padme, so that's a side right. note. So anyway, right. so I figured right. where Obi-Wan was going to be and all that stuff. But because you know,
a previous episode where I think bounty isn't as good as secret.
I was just, I think anyone with eyes and a brain oh. can understand that. But yes,
oh, it's very true.
Yeah,
because I didn't have to pick where I went.
My whole game plan, literally, my whole game plan was hinging on kill Obi-Wan with Bossk, keep Bossk alive. And then hope to God I can win on points destroyed.
And that's, you nearly did it.
That's how I can win the game. Whereas Will can just go, I'm just going to go this way. I'm just going to double move again. Okay. I win. That's, it's, oh, we're still going. Oh, okay. Yeah. We can play this thing. Out. That's fine.
So R2-D2 is going to just hide behind this other yeah. can of safety. And
yep. didn't even have to God. Hide.
I didn't God have to hide.
Damn trash can. yep, that's all that
you
happened.
Know, you make it really hard to defend you, Will. You make it real hard to defend you someday.
Oh, my God. Now, Palpatine was laughing. He was pulling the strings left and right. I did get to do a cool move, which also reminded me of something that was cool that Obi-Wan had that I forgot about. So, because Bossk was wounded, he had charge. Neat. So he charged into Obi-Wan by Palp pulling the string. So Palp pulled the string, he's got a move action, boom, triggered the whole kit and caboodle, got him into melee, got him off his other troopers. Hooray.
Obi-Wan had like 3 dodges at this point.
Yes, and in my mind, I was like, okay, cool, he's got dodges. I'm not going to shoot him, so I'll just get into melee with him so I can don't have to worry about deflect.
Incorrect.
I've not played against Obi in so long. Oh, I forgot no. completely, and this is on me, I just forgot. I forgot that he can deflect in melee.
The and snack so, that smacks right back.
Yeah, it was bad. So what was a great double attack in melee with Bossk ended up being his doom.
Yes, you did yeah. attack yourself to death.
Yes.
That's amazing.
Yep.
Stop it's, resisting.
It's exactly what happened.
Why do you keep slapping yourself, Bossk? Yeah. Why do you keep slapping yourself, Bossk?
And so Bosk died. I think, I didn't kill Obi-Wan with him. He was one health left.
Because then on turn 5, we both played our big one pips of doom.
Yes. Yes.
I played Hello There for like 8 tokens, and then Palpatine played Now You Will Die.
Which, Now You Will Die when, I mean, he's not immune to deflect, Palp. And so it's very terrifying. Because I'm shooting into him, and it can also come right back at me. And I'm like, well,
I had 6 dodges, yes. And nimble.
It's just, everything was, it was a terrible turn. I ended up killing him and Palp lived. But
every surge I rolled would have stopped another attack by Palpatine, but I got none.
Yep.
I just got blocks. How dare they?
Oh, boo. All my blocks. I just got, there's the name of the episode right there. I just got blocks.
I'm going to write that down because I'll forget.
But yes, and that's what happened. And so I did kill Obi-Wan, and Palp could have survived the rest of the game. But remember, kids, because bounty and the way bounty works, that doesn't frickin' matter. So therefore,
Palp was on one after melting Obi-Wan. He faded back behind this one piece of cover.
Yep.
And we kind of figured that because of R2 and the fact that most of his guys couldn't get to my VAPS.
Yep. Which also, if you ask why didn't I run to get his VAPS, I tried, but the entire clone army was waiting behind that coffee can. So,
which was in the middle.
Yeah, if you want to talk like, physically speaking, could I have run up to the evaporator? Yes. Would my troopers have survived long enough to do anything with that evaporator? No. So there's that answer.
I have a picture of my whole army behind the coffee can, so I'll post that when this goes live.
Oh,
so they can see the madness of 18 clones and Obi-Wan hiding behind one piece of terrain.
It was a solid list, though. What's really funny is I don't think I've played a game against ARCs since they've come out where they matter so little. Like I never
went the long way around. They shot like twice with their just their black dice, and it was
my snipers picked at him and kind of suppressed him or picked him off. We couldn't suppress him or vice versa.
Now you did have to shoot them a lot.
Yes. Oh, absolutely.
So they soaked a lot of damage with Impervious.
Yes, Impervious was a bitch and saved them multiple times over.
But because they were standing next to the phase twos to get that surge, so they'd just be like, thank you, we'll block
sure
that.
Sure was.
Block.
Couldn't get through.
Oh no, one arc. So yep. I was FFG. Kind of okay having them
FFG.
Be the soak.
Do you not
soak.
Hear these stories, FFG?
That's
like,
no,
they
know,
don't
You know, I wasn't going
to
do this.
They don't listen.
I wasn't going to do this in the last episode.
I hope they don't listen to us.
I hope not. That's also true. But you know, what happened in the last release
Hi,
we got
Alex
from the
Davey.
Germans? We got the list of playtesters. And so I hate to break out the list of playtesters.
No, Ben.
And publicly
Ben, don't
shame
you do that. No.
Ben.
All of them.
Ben.
I'm just saying,
Ben.
Perhaps FFG and playtesters, we should perhaps playtest either more or perhaps give these units to people who don't play so well so we can see what happens to the rest of us when we play against them.
Give them to us trash people is what we're saying.
You know, you're pretty mad for someone that doesn't play this
game.
Yeah,
you kind of are upset about someone who doesn't show up.
I played 4 games 4 weeks ago.
4 weeks ago,
that was four
man.
4 weeks ago.
Oh, man.
I know. I was 4 games, which is more than I played in the previous month and a half.
Oh, dear.
3 months.
Coating a turd in gold still makes it a golden turd.
But
which is what I'm saying about the playtesting.
But Tim's... Oh, wow.
Oh.
Man, the inebriated one here is trying to get us on topic. What's happening?
Some of them are good people, I'm sure. You know.
Like, oh, dear.
No. All right, let's take 5, guys. Let's circle back.
You can cut that out. Out. That's fine. Go fuck yourself. That is a good line. You know that was a good one.
While I'm editing this Tuesday night and sweating.
Yeah.
Exactly. I don't want to edit that out.
Ben, you should have said the names, and he could have just blanked out their names. It would have been great.
Just started a bleep.
I'm just saying some of them are very huggable Chicagoans, and I'm blaming you specifically for this one.
All right. I'm good.
Tim's list did make me sweat when I had all this situational awareness and he had all the high velocity. Just
yeah, screw
say,
your
nope,
SA.
Nope.
It was. It
so,
did feel good.
So losing Padme turn 1 didn't do Tim as much as it might have because her dodges weren't going to help anyways.
You can't sweat no more.
So it was still an interesting thing to try to tackle this entirely range 4/5 list. But, you know, R2 is broken, I guess. Along with everything else.
Gosh, it's just
except 35. Obi-Wan. Obi-Wan feels pretty good for what I paid for.
Yeah, no, he felt good.
And it was fun.
Obi-Wan's
just fun.
Yeah.
The model does help with that.
We could have called it before we did the whole, like, now you will die versus hello there, but I think we just wanted to see what would happen.
Yeah, we just wanted to see, like, honestly, I wanted to see if Palp would live. I wanted to see if Palp would make it through that.
I was hoping we'd both go down in it, like, his last attack kills him and me, and we're both just like, blah!
Yeah.
You know.
And see, this is where we could have gone, okay, now let's go to points destroyed, but again, we didn't. Just a reminder there. We couldn't do that.
I don't know who would have won points destroyed.
I don't know, but you know what? We'll never know. We'll never find out because it doesn't matter. So
it's true. Anyway. Thanks, 50 points, because I brought 3PO.
Yeah. Yeah, you really needed him.
I mean, it was just in case you wanted to shoot him. But thankfully, I didn't even have to hide.
So be sure to check out the Instagram where you can see pictures of Will's victory on the table with the beautiful model, because they are quite delightful.
R2 is so beautiful.
I also post pictures there, but you know, it's nice.
Post pictures.
Hey, look, honestly, I do love seeing pictures of models on the table. I really do. And as much as I love Tabletop Simulator, seeing those things on the Instagram, they make my heart filled with joy, despite the fact that I don't get to play this game anymore and the faction is broken. But you know, it's all fine. It's all fine.
Is it?
We're all fine here.
Everybody's fine.
2020 is going great. It's going great, guys. So fantastic.
Be sure to check us out on Facebook and Twitter, assuming society hasn't collapsed. Rate us on iTunes and subscribe on Spotify.
Well, theoretically, this podcast will release about the time we don't find out about the election on Wednesday morning. So, you know.
I do love if how you need the only person to laugh at Will's own jokes are Will.
The rest of us I'm hilarious, and you will quote everything I
just said. I was going.
If you need a Wednesday pick-me-up, here we are, dear listeners. We're here for you.
That's right.
Tune into Legion Academy live stream.
Let us nestle you.
Thanks for listening to the podcast that you're listening to right now at whatever platform you use. You're super cool, and I love you.
Let us nestle you into your new reality, whatever that may be. That's fine. And then also you can find on the Discord. We are technically all in Discord at STABcast, whatever our name is. Although currently I am, what is my name? My name
you
is...
You have all sorts of things going
everyone
on.
Everyone has value Tim. So there you go.
That's what a strange name for them to give you.
Yeah, to give you.
Well, it's because I was trying to... I was encouraging love and peace and all these other things that I need, I guess. I don't know. Again,
what lies do you tell the Discord?
I mean, you can't believe everything.
I'm currently STABcast Kato Bin, so...
Yes. But yes, you can find us on the Discord.
Yeah, you can check out our shirt shop at teespring.com/stores/STABcast, where if you
are we talking about the thing,
if you look down at your phone, we have a snazzy new logo and there will be some merch up on there to match. So
isn't it sexy?
There's gonna be thank you, Will. Yes, and there's gonna be we're gonna have t-shirts and sweatshirts and long sleeve shirts and even a STABcast fanny pack.
LVO.
It's there. Sure. I'll be wearing one.
Really, Tim?
Have one.
Tim and his fanny pack and his one quarter sleeves. And
I'll have one fanny pack for tokens sleeves. And one for booze. I'll need both.
Getting booze into LVO is tough. You gotta try hard.
Yeah, good luck.
I was about
with
to say,
yeah.
but they just want you to buy it there.
You can just buy it there. That's
as
fine.
Long as we have a bar in the room again, then it'll be okay.
Yeah, we'll be good. As long as we have LVO again, we'll be good.
I mean, we'll just say it's sanitizer.
Right.
If you want
your hand sanitizer doesn't contain alcohol.
If you want to communicate with us, drop us show topics or send Ben terrible lists to go out and play that he never will. Or send us some photos you want us to share on on our Instagram. You can send us
plays
an email
a listener
at
list once, never again.
At gmail.com.
Well, speaking of that, we did actually get a listener question/statement.
My God.
Had a lot of conversation this week. I know. And I want to tell you first, listeners, I don't respect your list building. I respect you as listeners. I love you as listeners. Your list building, though, leaves a little something to be desired.
This is why I
but
handle
I also realize
the,
part of that
listener
is because
segment.
It's really difficult to build a droid list. We're building a list for the clones that doesn't work. It's kind of hard.
Clones, you just toss the cards in the air and you still have a winning list.
I mean, Yeah. Three tanks is illegal. That's the only reason why you can't build that.
Right,
list,
right. So. And it would still be terrifying except for on boxes, but then I would just park my tanks on your boxes.
Exactly. Although, legally, I don't think you can. But, so here's the question we had. Serious next question. Says, serious question. Jeez. In dealing with terrain for area terrain, because he listened to our last podcast, and for that, we thank you.
Yep.
How applaud do you make your area terrain? I'm stuck with cutout felt and then adding a lone feature to denote what it is. Light forest, put a tree. Crystal patch, throw down a crystal. Rocks, etc. Listen, listeners, never be afraid of the felt. We talked about our river maps. All that is blue felt. Blue and I felt. Love that blue felt more felt than I love is ferocious. Will, Ryan, even Tim right now.
Well, that's
I love that blue felt. but no, but like embrace it. Like it's perfectly fine. And I know some people want photorealistic terrain. Good on you if you've got the skill to make it or the money to buy it.
Yep.
I mean, I love Scott's terrain building skills. He spent a lot of years practicing it. He's really good at it, and I will always praise him.
Yep.
I don't have it. I make fun with what I have. I put together little pieces that I can. And so, you know what? Don't be afraid of the felt. Find different and interesting trees, because honestly, with light area terrain where you have a lone tree to depict it, it's kind of nice not to have to jam models in and around a bunch of trees that are stuck to the piece.
Right.
Because that's just hard to do. And then it's a question like, well, I can kind of sort of see you because your gun's sticking out of this piece. And like, eh, listen, there's a tree here. It's all theoretical terrain.
Now, listener, now that the lame hobbyist has done talking, let me tell you about some cool ideas for area terrain.
Rivers. I'm telling you, rivers everywhere. Rivers are underused.
River stock is going
and
up.
So we, good. Rivers. Yeah.
River futures,
are,
since water's going to be scarce.
Those are rookie rivers. We got to boost those up. Come on. We got this.
I mean, I will throw some praise here for the first time in probably a year and a half. Dustin Harvey has a beautiful waterfall feature he made with some kind of, you know, acrylic glaze, and it's beautiful.
Yes, now, it is gorgeous.
He never brings it out of his house because he doesn't actually play this game live.
And it took him 30 days in his basement.
Well, no, that's not what he's paid for. So, you know.
Yeah. It looks really cool. If you're looking for quick ideas, something we all might end up with some scrap of is sprues. So if you're looking for rock terrain, you can cut up the little sprue frames you end up with and kind of make those into little bits.
Such a good idea.
If you have anything to cut like freeform shapes, like a bandsaw or a kind of skill saw kind of thing, you can make just whatever shape you want out of kind of quarter inch MDF and glue whatever you want on top of it. Mm-hmm. Little bits, little rocks, little craters, whatever you want. You can sculpt stuff. There's all kinds of ideas, and that's why I think area terrain is something we're advocating for, because it can be so flexible.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I mean, honestly, a foam cutter and cheap foam board from Home Depot, you can carve all sorts of things real easy, free-handed, and it'll be flat on one side and wavy and curvy on the other, and then you just throw glue and whatever at it.
Yep.
It'll be a gem mine, sparkly bits. Whee!
Now, the other thing...
Something I will compliment GW for, they make a great set of crater terrain, which a lot of people will say that's heavy. I like to think of it as light but difficult because of how it... You know, it's up to people's knees or so. I think it's kind of more appropriate that way.
Yep.
But they are great sculpts. They're great to use. They're really high detail and lightweight, thin plastic. They're not still sold. You'll have to find them on eBay, but they're a great set. I've painted up a set of them, and I loved them. And then I gave them to Sci-Fi City, and I don't know where they've gone.
The other cool thing that you can do with area terrain, and I think this is kind of getting to a bit of Tyler's question, is what I like to do is you've got your cardboard or your felt or whatever, and I would base it whatever you're doing your table on. So if it's rocks, get some rocky texture stuff. If it's water or if it's grass. But then what I would do is I would take little cardboard cutouts of the terrain you want to depict and base that as well, but then actually put physical representations on those things. And just before the match, tell your opponent, like, we're using these things. We have a lot of trees that we do this at Sci-Fi with that are on, like, old CDs. Right. And you can say, well, we can just pick these trees or these rocks or these grass tufts up and move them around as we need to, as long as they stay on the larger piece of cardboard or felt that is the area terrain. But then you can pick up the rocks and move them, knowing that that rock does not conceal a mini, because you've established that before the game began. This is a rocky outcropping that everything inside gets, you know, cover X. Or these tufts of grass, because a lot of times mini bases don't like to sit flat on them. You can move them around and So you're not sitting on them, but you know that if you're inside your that area, you've got the light cover that the grass would provide. So it's right. It's taking your cardboard and really doubling down on it and putting another piece of cardboard with some terrain on top of it. And that first larger piece of area terrain, literally all you need on it is maybe one thing if you want there to be some kind of line of sight blocker, or just some basing paste to create, or some flock to create whatever texture you want, and then putting smaller modular things on top of it. I think is the best way to create area terrain.
I mean, we laugh and joke about my farm, but I literally just bought like a tilled field and I glued that to the top of some cardboard. Yep. And then I took some fake, you know, succulents and like blump, blump, blump. It's now a field. And there's just enough fieldy things to make it feel fieldish. Yep. Without being covered and making it hard to put models on it.
It is very recognizable.
The only thing I wish about that, and if you were to do it again, the only thing I would do is not glue the plants down. If that makes sense.
I think it's because they're so heavy they don't want to fall. I know exactly what you mean. You can pull two of them out. Yeah.
But sometimes you want to sit exactly where that plant is to get that shot you need.
You sit on top, it's fine.
But yeah, that's how I would start crafting our area terrain. But at the end of the day, I know we want to be super emergent with our Star Wars and our miniatures gaming. But at the end of the day, sit down, dear listeners. Your tiny models do not actually shoot lasers out of them. So we are leaving already a lot up to the imagination. So if we got to do some with our terrain we can make that work.
Yeah. But I don't play this game anymore. So all I do is watch the War Corgi videos. And there's definitely laser bolts coming out of those.
There are. It's true.
Yeah. That's just science.
He has a much better budget than us.
Yeah, they do.
That's true. He has much better
budget. We don't have a budget.
You guys are getting paid?
Yeah. We sold, I think, 3 t-shirts this year.
Yeah, I think so. Wow. Something like that.
Which is good.
But now we have new ones. Buy a t-shirt.
Right. Also the was it one of them sleeves. To Brett and one of them to you?
Probably.
Yeah.
Thanks, probably third so. Person in Australia.
Yeah,
that's right.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up. Good luck to you, our Australian listeners, who have already played this past weekend for the Halloween Jamboree in Perth.
In Perth.
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 It's a beautiful city.
On the West Coast.
It's one of the cleanest cities I've ever seen in my life. So clean.
Yeah, at least it's
so
not pristine. Sydney.
Yes.
Watch so, it.
Last I episode, like we record on the weekends. And we had a very good suspicion and on pretty solid authority that we were going to be getting Anakin and Maul previews that coming week. And I said, guys, let's take a horrible, awful stab at what we think these units are going to do. And we did, and we were very wrong. So if you want to look at how wrong we are.
Was that a pun?
Yeah. Yes, it was.
Yeah.
Ew. And, yeah, it was, yeah.
And so now we actually have cards not in hand, but in digital hand, and pretty reasonably spoiled. Like, I don't know that there's anything in that pack that's still left up to the imagination.
No, we know everything that's in there. And also, dear listeners, if you ever want to say, like, I wonder if the STABcast guys have any kind of, like, insider information, just listen to their guesses.
There's
listen
the proof.
To the guesses of what they had last time to compare to what actually came out, and you'll be like, "Oh no, they don't
tester
know."
List and see that none of us are on it.
Yeah, we are not on there whatsoever. Because like, no. If we had been, I would have made my complaints known very early.
Oh, Ben would have burned down that playtester forum. Been like, whatever his fake name is, I don't want this in my game ever. And they're like, exactly. Well, he's at the publisher already.
Uh-oh, don't tell Ben.
And who could he be talking about?
Who could tell? Speaking of who he's not talking
about.
But
the stabbing expert himself, Anakin Skywalker, Edgelord Supreme.
Oh, so edgelordy. So, I mean, I like the art on him, but it's definitely angry Anakin.
Oh, he's giving you the choke.
Yes, he is.
And not
yes,
in like a cool way.
No, he's
isn't angry. I'm murdering the children yet. He's going to do that in about 30 minutes.
Not that that's cool either, listeners. Let's clarify that. Oh, God. That's also not okay.
It's slightly cool.
No. No, it's not. No, thank you.
He's got to be an apologist.
Well, now I know who's not invited to the cool kids club.
Because we're all things we knew. So, things we knew already, right?
Right.
Jump.
We knew he was going to have the jump. We knew he had a flaw card. We knew he was a Jedi, so he's going to be immune to pierce. Roger, roger, check, check. All that kind of stuff.
We knew the names of his command cards, and we knew the keywords that might be sprinkled around on them.
Right. Yes. Because it's always a matter of combination of keywords and then what the actual flaw card would do.
Right.
And what
and now we have it all laid out before us.
We're going to look like. That's the other big one, is what upgrade slots we got.
That's true.
Right, right. So now we have him, Anakin Skywalker, 160 points. I'm just going to read his printed card, and then we'll get to all the nonsense.
Yeah.
So we've got two force and two trainings for some reason.
He's gross. It is absolutely gross. Luke had two trainings.
Well, we can't all be clone players, I guess. Unless we all have to be.
Unless we're all clone players.
Yeah, unless we all switch.
We have the jump one, we have the flawed, we have the immune pierce, all standard. Mm-hmm. We have gem so mastery, which is, while defending, if you spend a dodge token, you gain surge block. And then, if at least one hit or crit result was canceled, the attacker just suffers a wound.
So, I like it. It's much more consistent than any deflect.
Yeah, you don't have to... The surge results don't cause wounds, but you just get one if now, you roll the block or used your dodge against a hit.
And but it works in both, though. Both melee and ranged.
Which it's any time.
Now, does the...
I mean, I know that Will has had that beautiful day.
Get you... does it get you the dodge to get rid of a hit, just like deflect does, as well as... So do you just spend a dodge and deal a damage? Or do you have to block a dodge with a block?
Well, I believe the text on deflect is if you spend a dodge token, you gain surge block. Right?
Right, which is, the same here.
Because we can... So it's the same trigger, which is just spending a dodge to cancel a hit.
Yes.
Yeah, honestly, yeah. I would say so.
Which would cancel one hit to trigger the secondary ability.
Because there's definitely a semicolon there. Yeah.
Yeah.
Seems real good.
Pretty strong. So if Anakin has dodge tokens, don't mess with him. Although Obi-Wan could deal you more, but he's definitely dealing you one.
Right.
So
right.
It's interesting.
We've seen those quarter cases where Obi-Wan's like, I'm going to surge all my defense die and murder an entire squad of human beings.
Oh, I have stories.
We saw that happen. I saw it happen live on a stream.
I've definitely had a Son of Skywalker deal more damage to Luke than to Obi-Wan.
Gross. That's not right.
It was three to Luke and one to me.
So, but we've also played it where none of us got the deflect off.
Yes.
Like we spent that thing as like nope.
Like when I played Tim and all I rolled was blocks.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just wiping my tears with dodge tokens.
Yeah.
So I like it. It's at least much more consistent. You're going to want to kill this man early.
I do like it.
God forbid he gets all three cards out.
Then the other ability printed on him is Tempted. He can equip force upgrades of any alignment.
Woo-hoo.
Neat.
Not shocking.
That's real neat. Yeah.
We have a red save. We have 6 wounds and 3 bravery. Surges on nothing printed.
Right.
Speed 2. Anakin's lightsaber is a measly 5 red dice.
Not quite Vader. We're not quite to Vader level yet. But
with a small Impact 3 and Pierce 3.
It's that Impact 3 that Pierce 3 that's bananas.
Yeah.
It's straight banana land.
It's such banana. It's better than Luke's. Hooray.
I did think that Gem So might be a bit more offensive than what we got, but I still think this is a really cool ability.
It's probably the best mastery we've seen so far by a fair margin.
Obi-Wan's has the potential to be better, but they're both very good, I think. Dooku's is also pretty good. I think all the masteries have been good.
No, they've all been great, don't get me wrong. Now,
including the one we're going to talk about in a minute.
Yeah, once again, Ben, English major, do you have to spend a dodge token with the semicolon in order to get the Gem So mastery? Or if you just normally block a hit, do they take a wound without spending a dodge token?
Oh, dear.
So... I would read that you would have to spin the dodge token.
Okay.
I would hope so.
Because the semicolon connects the second piece to the first piece.
Yeah, that's absolutely. So, wait, why is that a question? That's absolutely how it's
done. Then why did they
We're just checking.
I'm really curious why they didn't just say spend a dodge token to deal a wound.
That's
to give you the keep it phrased in a consistent way. Rules writing has to be in a certain framework.
Yeah. Right.
That's what I would say. The rules writing have to be in a certain framework.
You're one to talk about English.
Oh, I know. Because you can spend a dodge token to cancel no hits.
Right.
Yes.
I mean.
That's right. As long as you spend a dodge token, you get to do that extra super duper ability too. Like,
but you have to cancel a hit.
If you cancel a hit. So, yeah. I like that they include aura crit for when you bring situational awareness with your free extra training slot. Fixing
the problems we've already taken and broken.
Yes. But you might not need situational awareness, as we'll get to. Then we'll start with his one pip. His one pip. This is where the fun begins.
No. Love the title?
In which he's like skydiving for fun because he's Anakin and he's immortal and all that stuff. It orders himself like a one pip do.
Like it does.
It is traded permanent, like all his command cards, and it gives him outmaneuver and relentless.
So he doesn't even need to take SA.
Correct.
That is one thing to note, however, about his card above, is he does not have charge.
Correct.
That is a notable exception.
But his one pip gives him relentless for the rest of the game.
But he can get relentless. Yep. Yes.
It also permanently tacks on that at the end of his activation, if he was not the first friendly unit to activate, he gains one suppression. Because he's a petulant child boy.
Yep.
Whiny Anakin.
I will say, in our predictions last week, I was like, we knew there's going to be something negative attached to every card. We had the preview of that first one.
Right.
Of his three pip. But is it going to be enough? And I will say, making him go first when you don't want him to go first is a hardship there.
Yeah.
Now, where are you traditionally going to play this one pip when you want him to go first? But if you really want the outmaneuver relentless at the beginning, if you really do need it.
Yeah.
That's exactly.
But then how many does he actually live beyond that and all sorts of things like that? You know.
So the negative here can be impactful. Yes. It can.
Especially
but since
because...
you have two trainings, one of them can be relentless.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's also interesting that on some of the other permanent cards, like Cad Bane and Padme's we see, and it's also because they are divulge cards, but how the text boxes are subdivided to where you only keep, like, only part of the card is permanent. The bad part, the way you would get suppression is permanent too. So it's not only going with him first on the turn where you play his one pip, but it's whenever you play that, he has to go first for the rest of the round or the rest of the game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what I tried to influence that it's also permanent at the end of his activation, blah, 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 suppression.
In those games where you mess up and you deploy badly or the table isn't helping you at all, you might need to drop this early enough for the outmaneuver.
Sure.
Yeah.
Like, or if you're really playing a heavy suppression game, you need the relentless just to get the attack on the movement. Mm-hmm. Like, there's places I can see where that would be, you have to do it in a way you don't like to.
It's not a traditional one pip that kind of like takes you from a charging melee monster to like, you know, Luke attacking twice or things like that.
I'll go ahead and say what Will's dancing around. It's a bad one pip.
Yeah.
Ooh, hot takes.
It's not traditional.
No, but nothing about it.
It's not as explosive as one pips tend to be.
Because you're going to want to play his two pip before that.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Because his two pip, you underestimate my power.
Oh, whiny.
Because he's starting to whine now that he's gotten a few suppressions. Is also permanent and only orders himself.
I do like that.
Anakin Skywalker gains Surge Crit.
Hate it.
And Master of the Force 1.
Also hate it.
However, permanently, he gains the following text. At the end of his activation, if he did not attack something, he gains one suppression. Because he's getting all edgy.
Yep.
So... I know we made the joke they wouldn't give him Master of the Force because wouldn't that be funny? Because he's not actually a master, even though he sits on the council.
Oh, we knew it was going to come on one of these cards as soon as we saw the three pip back at Gen
Con. He's not a rebel hero. Jeez.
Yeah.
Oh.
I get the surge crit. I do as a permanent. I do wonder if that weakness is as bad as it sounds. Because at this point, when you have him doing those things, aren't you going to be attacking with him every turn?
Well, it depends where he is. Because if you want to try to like stack this stuff up, then it's going to be difficult to get these things going without like three suppression by turn four.
Or he's murdered everybody.
Or that. Like, there's definitely a scenario where he just...
He can't attack anyone because no one's close enough.
The other thing to consider,
or he just
though,
pinball then. Wizards through your whole army. You know, it could just happen.
All of these are really good card effects, and they all stack really well. I don't think the flaws are debilitating. But when you look at his one pip compared to all the other lightsaber wielder one pips, and when you look at his lightsaber itself, it's five very consistent dice, but it's still just five dice.
They're not attacking twice. They're not dealing extra damage.
Yeah, they're not. It's going to be harder for him to, like, there's no Son of Skywalker. There's no, what's Grievous's one pip?
Train in the Jedi Arts.
Yeah, thank you.
It's not Hello There, where you can get two attacks off of the standby. Yeah,
I think he's going to do a lot of damage consistently, but he's never going to have that big supernova turn that, like, Implacable can have or some of the others.
Like, he's very good at crowd control, honestly. Mm-hmm. Like, he's going to be way better at just, where's your core army? I'm going to scythe through it on turn three or turn two. With, you know, now I have Relentless and Surge Crit, and I'm just wailing on squads, getting probably five hits each time with Pierce 3.
Literally go 3-2-1? Or 3?
I think the game is going to depend on it, and depending on whatever else is going on, you might have, if you're bringing a second commander, depending on what our generics do, you may have to throw some of those other cards off in the distance anyway.
Yeah, like if you're running Anakin Rex, you're going to want Tick That Clankers on turn 2 or 3 instead of one of these cards. But also, you don't want Anakin to suck. So now, it's going to be...
I think there's definitely... You have to play Hero of the Clone Wars first to get that Exemplar and Reliable going early. And that way the rest of your army can benefit from it.
I think
you have flexibility.
Yeah. That's pretty safe.
The other thing that makes me a little giddy, though, is going back to what I was talking about earlier. Does this put Han back in the game? No. No, it doesn't. No. But change of plans against an Anakin list is going to be a hell of a lot of fun.
Yeah, it is. It's going to be that and a flaw at the same time. It's
especially that will never matter.
Especially if he's done that 3, then 2, and he's like about to play that one pip, and you're going to be like, oh, I'm about to ruin this man's whole career.
He's still going to win.
Watch him not have Relentless. Watching him not have Relentless when he's two moves away from you and about to play his one pip is going to be delicious.
That is going to be absolutely delicious.
You can Brett your way to like a sweet, sweet moral victory while the other clones shoot your army to death.
Right. Moral victory is just another way of saying defeat.
We're still on the two pip, kind of.
Yeah. Well, so, I mean, because we know what the three pip does. Exemplar, Reliable, too. If you're not friendly. Yeah.
Yeah.
So I think the Master of the Force is the thing that's going to be interesting because it depends on which Force upgrades you take with you.
Right.
You may not need Master of the Force.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I mean, actually, if you take Saber Throw,
not need it. Yeah.
I think it's, and so in that case, you don't care when that two pip drops.
I think it's Throw Push.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm saying I can see a case where you may not bring it at all.
Nope. Here's what I'm.
No.
No.
You're right.
And if you have Throw, you can get around that not performing an attack at all. All
right. You don't need Surge Crit. What I will say, Ben, is if you were to
Vader drop players an can Anakin tell you otherwise.
Card, if you're going to drop an Anakin card, this is the one to drop. I just don't think you're going to drop one.
But you're not going to. No, absolutely.
Yeah, exactly.
No, I think Ben, I think if you're bringing Anakin, these cards are basically part of him. Like, it's not really like other commanders where it's these are neat abilities that your commander can do. It's no, you're still building the jigsaw puzzle that is this boy with issues.
Right.
Now,
speaking of issues.
Well, hold on. We want to talk about different force loadouts. Why not just take reflexes?
I
think it's a cool place to chat because I think there are lots of different ways you can build it.
This is where I'm getting at. I think there are places where you don't need to have it. So that's why I'm wondering what force upgrades, because you only get two. And you don't start with Master of the Force. So things like Choke, which I love, when you can't refresh that automatically, it becomes real hard.
You bring choke and reflexes. And that's two or three damage a turn.
You bring Force Choke.
At range one with the Choke.
Those are the two best Force cards in the game. You bring Force Choke and you bring Force Push.
All right. And you use them on a single turn.
Okay.
Well, it depends if you have Padme.
Yeah.
If you have Padme and Anakin can spend her dodges to cause damage, then it's still a great time.
Yeah, that's true.
Yep.
That's true. I don't think.
All right, so I completely see not bringing reflex. I'm perfectly fine with that. But I mean, when you have choke and push, like you use them once, and then if you've played the card, you get one of them back. Are you going to spend one of your actions to refresh every time? You see what I'm saying? Like, so when we're so used to having Master of the Force to re-up those every time we want them.
Well, hold on, we say we.
Not having that, I think, is an interesting play.
But things like push, you're not using until you're in the fight, which hopefully you've played as one pip to get in there, and maybe you've had the two pip the round before that. I don't know. I think you're right that there are cases where you're going to bring... You could bring fear and hope and just be like, I am the master of tokens.
I mean, yeah, you could.
I love it.
You could.
All right. I will inspire and uninspire one every round. Hooray.
You could also put battle meditation on him. You're not going to, but like, yeah.
Correct.
It's a thing you can do.
You could do.
Yeah.
He also comes with barrier that he probably won't take. He'll just hand it to his good buddy Obi-Wan.
Yeah, Obi-Wan brings barrier left and right. That's different.
Oh my, yes.
Yeah.
If I didn't say it enough in our battle report.
Okay. We'll get there.
All right, so let's talk about this flaw card. Let's talk about this flaw. Now that we've got
now that Ryan's ready to talk about it, let's talk about it.
Yeah, now that Ryan's told me not to talk about it three times.
Well, no, I think we need to build the puzzle of the things. Because
it's not a puzzle, just read the directions.
God, y'all are insufferable tonight.
My arm's been stronged so hard.
You have to set up this idea of how to make this flaw card actually work. If we just read it out at the start of the show, we don't know why suppression's going to matter or why this ability is going to matter. Because honestly, you want to sit on this flaw card to where you can really start to upset him with these. Because you can get him in a spot, and I do think by turn four, turn five, he may very well get to that spot. Where he's going to just take three suppression over the course of the turn, and with missing some of his crucial keywords, Anakin on one action sounds real, real bad. So his flaw card is you hand it to your opponent, and during the command phase, you can hand that card back to your opponent, and Anakin may not be issued an order token.
If he has one suppression token.
Right.
Yes. Yes.
Which
he probably will.
There's not much, I don't think, if anything, that can affect suppression tokens at the start of the command phase.
No, I mean, it's the start of the command phase, and if he has Relentless, he's just picked up two, so it's...
You mean Endurance.
Endurance, sorry.
Yeah. No, you're good.
He has Relentless from his card.
Yeah.
But I understand Ryan not wanting us to talk about it, since it's not a story the Jedi would tell you.
Kill
him.
With that, I'm out. I retired. Goodbye, everyone. Talk about Maul. Goodbye.
I will say that I don't like the flaw card. It's interesting. It is, but I don't know denying an order token is...
It doesn't do enough. It can trigger his one pip's ability to make it so that he's not going first unless they just have godly luck with bag pull.
Yeah. So I'm at two suppression.
It means he's not just obliterating your Grievous with the first action, so Grievous could maybe go first and suppress my whole clone ball.
No, I could see it adding up if you're not careful with it.
It's not just about that suppression, it's about him not getting the token.
Because all three of his cards, like most commanders, it's the timing. But not all of them require, and two of them are just him, so you may be putting your opponent to put all of their tokens in the bag. Which feels bad, especially as a clone player. Really bad as a CIS player.
Well, except for my HQ uplinked fives that makes another token. But yeah.
But there's ways of getting that token
to Anakin. So.
Yes.
I think if you can do enough bag control, you can still pull it. I mean.
But also, I don't want a card that debilitates your game.
For a free ability I'm handing to my opponent, it is a strong card.
I think it's interesting. I think, listen, the long and short, you want to, for those that somehow managed to skip ahead right to this part, the long story short on Anakin is he is a high skill ceiling player or unit, but if you can pull it off, he's going to be great.
But if he gets evaporated, he
can get suppressed off the board real easily, and all of a sudden you're going to have a screaming mini Vader running away. And real Vader is going to be like, I don't do that. Of course, he also doesn't see the table.
He's going to look for some women and the children, too.
Oh, to cheer himself up. Like,
yeah.
It's that Robot Chicken episode now, with the daisies.
I will give you the, things go wrong, if your stacking of cards is played out where you can't do the things in order to get it, he will be suppressed quickly. And then if you put enough shots into him and he survives them, as you know, as Jedi often do, then he's going to be, he may be close enough to actually panic off the board like certain Grievouses.
Yeah.
I mean, if you end up not putting endurance on him, it's a real. But so let me ask you, Will, do you staple endurance to him?
Probably.
Yeah.
With all his suppression abilities.
I think you have to.
All right. Can I think it's endurance and then whatever else. Why not?
Sure.
You don't have Master of the Force. So a refresh is not a terrible thing if you're clearing suppression and getting force powers back. Luke player who's learned to play with that.
It's kind of terrible, though.
Well, the two Luke ops I've played against in the online league, that's exactly what they would do. They would refresh where they needed to. And then that cleared up a lot of their tokens to do the rest.
Yeah. Well, I'm talking about Commander Luke, who doesn't have Master of the Force. Right. Like he doesn't have that option, and he also, like Anakin, has to kind of wade through battle with no real reasonable ranged option.
You get two red dice with no sharpshooter.
No sharpshooter.
I would get four red dice with no sharpshooter in Pierce 3.
You know who else gets four red dice in a range shot?
You would get three. Hey, and I also, can't count. It's
that
fine.
Version of Anakin's lightsaber is also slightly broken, so it throws worse dice.
That's right.
Who's?
Isn't Luke's Anakin's lightsaber throw?
Yeah, it's five black dice. Yes. Or is it six? Yeah. I think it's six.
Eventually, Rey's saber is just going to throw all white dice. That's it.
Yep.
But it'll be 12.
But it'll be 17 of them.
Surge crit.
They'll introduce new yellow dice just
for the famous Mary Sue saber. What?
I'm surprised Anakin's card doesn't say Rey's lightsaber at the bottom.
Right.
Wait, no, we still have one more. Come on, we still got another unit left. Go ahead.
Yep. Let's talk about our favorite red friend here.
God,
our favorite
so
three
scary.
Lines friend.
Oh, I do. He's going to be incredibly scary.
Let's talk about the one.
I absolutely love him. I do love him. I do. So it's Maul. He's 160 points. Yeah. He's jump one. He does have deflect. So when you spend a dodge token, you gain a surge to block. Range attack, of course, they will suffer a wound for each of those surges rolled. Immune pierce, which we love. This mastery. Oh, I love this mastery.
It's so good.
Mastery. While you are wounded, you can perform one additional action during your activation, limit to two move actions.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, it's so good. It's better
two force
charge.
Powers.
He doesn't have charge, it really but it's better than charge.
Because it gives you options. It gives you flexibility.
Exactly.
I mean, two force powers, two trainings. It is six wounds, three bravery here. Red defense die, no surges, movement of two.
Yep.
His double-bladed lightsaber. Four red dice, four white dice.
Yep.
Impact two, pierce two.
Delicious.
Whew.
Yes.
Whew.
Highest damage potential of a lightsaber wielder. Full stop. I mean, potential is a strong word, but...
Yeah, no, but
he's going to have some surge. He's going to have some surge tokens.
Yeah, he's going to have some aims too. Yep. He's going to have
Some aims from some friends
and tenacity going on. Don't forget the tenacity. He's going to throw in that extra die because if you're not bringing tenacity on him, you're insane.
Why? I mean, you're going to get the free red die.
You're absolutely uncocaine. Like you need to bring tenacity on him.
Why throw eight dice when you could throw nine?
Right. I mean, Ryan said it best when he first came out. Like. He's going to be a 5 health unit, really. I mean, he's not 6 health. Yeah. He's really a 5 health unit, which is fine.
He's going to be a 5 health unit.
Because he's a terrifying 5 health unit.
Mm-hmm. He sure is.
Absolutely terrifying.
Three actions seems pretty rad, even if there is the one attack and two movement limitation, if you want to call that a limitation.
If you want to call the limitation. I mean, being able to jump and then move into melee and then smack someone in the face.
Yep.
Yeah.
Or move and then jump and then smack someone in the face.
I'm glad they prevented the problem faction from breaking the game more.
So here's I think the coolest thing about the mastery though. It's the
Tell us.
It's the move attack, and then you're probably gonna wipe whoever you wipe. And the problem with that is most, melee units is now once you kill someone.
unless it's the end of the round, you're about to get the crap shot out of you. And now you can just use your third action to charge into somebody else and bubble wrap yourself in a nice warm safety blanket.
Just tiptoe through the tulips to the next unit.
Yep.
And the tulips are all the dead.
Because I have done that. I was like, please, please, Grievous, please don't destroy everybody. Please, Grievous, keep someone.
Just keep one dude alive, Grievous.
You didn't keep that one dude alive. All right.
Oh, yeah. There's definitely Grievous defense rolls that I'm like, all right, everybody, if you could blank out for me here.
Exactly. I'm sacrificing you to the greater glory of the army.
I need you to die so I can shoot him to death with a fire support, please. Yep. Thank you. Oh, there it is. Great job, Grievous. You killed everybody.
I mean, I think, Will, did you once not spend a surge token just for that one reason?
I did. Yep. I could have spent a surge to keep one man alive, and I said, thank you for your service to the Republic, and let him die.
That's right.
I'm going to jump to his cards. He's so good. I'm going to jump to his cards. We're going to come back just a minute for his additional flavors.
Yeah.
So we know his titles. We saw them. I do love the titles of these things. I mean, At Last, Duel of the Fates, Phantom Menace. They're just so good.
But
so
none of them talk about the sparse population of Tatooine, Ben.
I'll bring in the music if I have to.
That's right.
I mean, but all right. So At Last, his three pip. Except it's not a three pip. It's a one pip.
My love has come along.
I was hoping you were going to mute yourself so I wouldn't hear it. And you were just singing along the background and let Will just gently lift it into the show.
Listen, bum, I know bum, I'm about to jump ahead, bum. But that pose in the Phantom Menace card is him just continuing on and going like, the Sith of my life, and I'll kill all your friends and everyone before you.
I mean, you're not wrong about this at all, Tim. I'll let you karaoke this one out.
Hey, like, go ahead. At last, please. Go ahead. At last.
It's the truth.
So,
can it, Will?
So here's one of the things. So At Last, his three pip, which is actually his one pip, because he counts as his three pip. Maul gains an aim token. Cool. Love it. Jedi Hunter. Oh, great. Hot. We're about to engage with some Jedi. Yep. Give me some surge. And then when he activates, he gets to suffer a wound.
He may. The key word there is may.
He doesn't have to suffer that wound. But if you're like, man, I really wish I had my tenacity going, hey, I got you,
I really love that third action and tenacity right before I jump in there.
Yep.
Yeah.
Ooh, a little bloodletting. Let me just cut my thumb a little bit.
Yeah.
This is for you.
It's like impervious, but good.
Cut myself in two pieces.
Now,
I'm sorry, not impervious. I'm sorry, implacable. I'm so sorry. I butchered that. It's like implacable, but good.
Implacable's good?
Yeah. But not as good as this.
It was good 2 years ago.
Okay.
It's delayed gratification.
So is Han.
I mean, if Vader lives long enough to see his token again, it's fantastic. Yeah. Often, though, he doesn't.
Right, exactly. But anyway, back to Maul.
Yeah, the thing to note about this, though, is, you know, we've talked about his other one pip before where you gain disengage and people you're engaged with can't spend tokens. He also, like Anakin, doesn't have a double tap. And that is
he does
that
not.
Is interesting. I mean, it's a hell of a single tap, but there is no double tap.
I mean, theoretically, the only printed double tap is the Son of Skywalker. Like, Grievous's is more of a tap everything, and Obi-Wan's is a react to everything. So, like, but I get what you're saying. It's not that direct, like, here's more threat.
Yeah.
It's a different kind of threat.
Palpatine's is a pretty direct double tap. Implacables, if you're not attacking.
Oh, it's a quadruple tap.
Yeah. And even Dooku can do some gets multi attack.
Kinda,
he did two things. Yeah.
Yeah. So it's interesting that they don't have access to that. They don't have the big supernova turns that the other characters
right
do.
Now. Instead, of course, his the one three pip here. His three pip one pip. It only lasts for the turn, so you only get the surge the once, but it's perfectly fine.
Yep.
It's normally something you're going to do anyway.
Hopefully, they're
and now
after
the Jedi
that.
Are becoming much more you know on the table a lot more often.
Right.
Except for in the Imperials. So if you go up against the Imperials, good luck on that, Ben.
but it's still a third one pip in your list, and even if they're not running, any Force users, like if you're playing a mirror match with a Grievous. Or a rebel player who hasn't taken Luke, it's still a good card because you're still getting an extra one pip on them, and you're still getting to turn on your abilities at will. So,
and your droids, so your army has tokens anyways if you brought HQs and stuff.
Yep. Right. Oh, yeah. And honestly, picking up a free aim before you get that third action allows you the flexibility to do whatever you want to.
Yep. Or take another aim for your eight dice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Exactly. Because you're going to need them with those white dice. Oh, yeah. No.
So, you know, we were talking a little bit Phantom about Menace. This before the show on how he doesn't have a gear slot because we're afraid of E-stims. I'm more afraid of him having a gear slot for targeting scopes with the amount of aims you're going to put on him.
Sure. Oh, that's totally fair. Totally fair. For
I can see that.
4 points, yeah.
Yeah.
Because he's probably going to have offensive push in one of those training slots and tenacity in the other. So, and you don't have Master of the Force, so refresh is not a bad option, and you have three actions, so it hurts a lot less.
Right. And, on his four slots, he's got some good options there, obviously, but I mean, you're going to...
That's a very good option.
I'm telling you, you got to put push in there. Absolutely, because with push, with that extra action, his threat range should be, according to mathematicians that I know and love dearly, should be 15.7. 15.7 inches.
Other than people you care
about? Nope, I sure don't. Okay. Nope. 15.7 inches.
I will say Tim started this podcast before we recorded saying, yeah, his range is like 21.6.
All right.
And then he said it was like 16.2. And now we're at 15.7, so it just keeps shrinking, which is the opposite of a
it's lowering. Just know. Like
it was cold outside
of Tim Shue. Yes,
it was.
He's got his double-bladed lightsaber, and he's like, "I swear this never happens."
Both sides are supposed to ignite. Both sides ignite. I'm telling you.
This kid named Obi-Wan sliced it in half, and now there's all kinds of problems happening.
Just pop a probe droid; you'll be good in a couple hours. Yeah. It's all right.
All right. Tell us about his.
I just got to observe for a little while. Go
ahead. Maul 2-pip. So, if you just played normal during the game, Maul cannot attack. Enemy units beyond range 2 of Maul cannot attack him.
Right.
Neat.
It is very neat. It is very interesting. I don't know that I'll ever want to play it that way. Because what I really want to do is take it for the bottom half, which is divulge, deploy unit step.
Oh, we know.
Yes. Maul gains infiltrate. And then during the first round, Maul and any friendly DRK-1 Sith probe droids who happen to just be right next to him can't perform objective card actions.
Right. And then
they can still attack.
But hold on, you're missing the most important thing in this card, other than obviously like what it directly does. Discard this card after it is revealed, which means you discard it immediately, and then your opponent still does not know what you're going to play.
It does not make you play it turn one.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
I did not read that.
You discard it, and you immediately will then play another card instead.
It's not like Darkness Descends or Padme's card where you have to play it turn one and it does nothing.
It's not a permanent thing, technically. I mean, it's kind of permanent because it's like the effects stay, but...
It gives you the infiltrate that one time you need.
Right. Well, and also the bottom text.
I'm going to need a moment alone. I'm just going to...
So you can still drop this and play your whatever you want turn one.
Yep. Yeah. You can still do whatever you want turn one. Which could be...
One pip.
It could be one pip.
I actually...
Oh, my.
It is really strong. Watching Ben learn how to infiltrate will be fun.
Welcome to the welcome to the pack.
I've screwed it up three times and I've tried.
Welcome to the fun. It's great.
But honestly, I don't hate the top half of that card. Two approach, maybe even turn one, to keep him safe if you've got to cross a no man's land.
It's kind of better than Luke's new 3-pip where he doesn't get shot at or whatever that is.
Right.
Oh, it's way better than that.
I mean, like Ryan said, it keeps you safe in that no man's land. I mean, hell, this is a huge thing with clones right now, right? Like, you can run pretty much through any standby bubble, even just a regular, like an Overwatch standby bubble, and just be like, la 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 la. Like, there you go.
That's very, very true.
Yeah.
But what stops him from just moving to range 2?
Okay, but hopefully you get to where you're trying to go first.
Maul has an order token, and you activate him last.
Yeah.
Yeah, into the standby. That's true. Into the standby, you know, nonsense.
Right.
I do like it because, you know, those units that get that extra range because, you know, take that clankers. Right. He still doesn't care about that.
Yep.
I mean, no. I mean, I do actually like that top part. I do. I know my play style, and I would be very leery about when to play that, but...
Yeah. But you get to infiltrate him and his droids because they deploy.
Yeah, I was going to say, that's the other big thing, too, is now those droids, which can observe up to range 3... And now they're able to immediately observe things.
And have a cool keyword that says I don't get to just obliterate them.
Yeah.
But let's go talk about the droids. Yep. That's the reason why I saved them.
Yeah.
Because I absolutely love these boys. And yes, they do have detachment Maul. You have to play Maul in order to get them.
Yeah, who cares?
Oh, no.
They are only 35 points.
Yeah. Whatever
they do get
shall
a comms unit.
Comms unit is great for them too.
You get three models, which I do love.
Yep.
Because what's about to happen here? One health, one bravery. They are my special forces. White dice. They surge on both, which I found to be kind of interesting.
Yep.
Welcome to be.
They're overpowered. They surge on both.
They do. They're overpowered. OP.
They're better than your B1s. It's happening,
Ryan.
They're
better than my B1s.
It's finally happened.
They get hover air, so they get to ignore terrain height one or lower.
Yep. Which
so yeah. That's kind of nice.
And cool they don't have to move, which other hover things have to.
That's
so far.
Yeah. I was gonna say you'll notice that's a big difference where it doesn't say speeder one; it just says hover one.
It's just hover air. They are incognito. Enemy units beyond range one cannot attack unless you have attacked, defended against an enemy attack, or performed an objective card action.
Yep.
Yeah, so listen, guys, I'm not here. It's not a big deal.
I'm just not a big deal. It's not a big deal.
You know, it's not an objective card action? Observe. Observe is not an objective. So you can just.
What might that do?
Just observe.
For an action, choose an enemy unit at range 1 to 3, and in line of sight, 8 gains 3 observation tokens.
Mm-hmm. Unless they're clones, right?
Now, observation tokens, you put them on an enemy unit, and then when you're attacking said enemy unit, your units can spend one to reroll a single die.
Yes.
They're mini aims. They're mini aims, but it's on a target of your choosing, so that your units don't have to have an aim token themselves. They don't have to waste the action getting it.
I could see this being so good in so many different situations, but I'm thinking of maybe just because I played against Obi-Wan recently. But I'm thinking of Obi-Wan's marching down the field, and we just want to pour everything into him, maybe before you get some dodge tokens on him or something, or whoever your commander of choice is, or your enemy's choice, rather. And whoever you want to kill, whoever you want to whittle down, just throw it on them and observe them. And then everyone can reroll to their heart's content.
Here's where my brain went. My brain went someplace else, Tim. Observation tokens, especially for CIS players. Wouldn't it be great if you didn't have to spend your aim tokens on your BXs to reroll your dice, but if you could save that aim token for lethal? And you're getting your fixed rerolls through
tokens that the BXs will have.
I don't have a lot of aim tokens on those guys. It is nice to save because I have had red dice do blank surge once or blank. Yep. I mean, I did have something that happened once. I was like, that's gross.
It sure does.
The one time I happened to have an aim token. But no, it would be nice to be able to save those aims for other pieces. It would be great for when I happen to have an aim token on a B1. And then I can actually reroll more dice. You know, I could do the things that clones do, which is reroll all the things.
Mm-hmm. So, FFG, I'm going to need to know when I will be able to use observe tokens, because, I am your loved only child, and I need those in my life.
Papa FFG,
I don't have enough dice modifications.
And listen, so you can do this from range 3, and because you have 3 models, you can coheed in ways where you hide them behind walls, so only one guy's hanging out there looking at things,
right?
Which I do love, which keeps them alive a little bit longer. But also, let's say we're out of observation tokens. It's time, to kick some behind. And so then you can just start shooting with them. Range 1 to 2 or melee, which I love. 2 white dice and suppressive.
Mm-hmm.
It's a Z6 when all 3 of them are shooting that surges and is suppressive.
Yeah.
And theoretically, they could dump their observe tokens and just reroll for themselves.
Yeah.
Now, the thing, and as soon as we saw this card, I messaged Ben. I was like, Ben, you're going to have to fight every urge within your body to just not, observe, shoot, whatever you just observed.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be real hard for me, blah. I just got so excited, and I shot everything right there.
That's
just
right. You sure got him, Ned.
We also talked about last show about how shorter range units are better at dealing with magic trash cans. And,
yes.
6 white dice with, 3 rerolls that surge seems like a pretty okay way to try to deal with a magic trash can.
He won't die.
And you can even tie him with melee, since they can get engaged and slow him down as he plods toward his secret mission.
Yep. Do you know what doesn't stop me in my movement? A barricade.
You're right. You know what kills your 3 wounds of health? R2's zap and a clumsy kick.
That's it. So I don't know when we got to, Battle Wars or whatever that show was. We had
Battle Bots.
All I know is these 35 points seem a lot more overpowered because they can definitely win games.
You get out.
I still have a secret mission, but it's fine. It's all fine.
You see, this is called bad faith.
Bad faith argument. So I will say, since it does have a comm slot, I could theoretically give it HQ uplink if I just really wanted to.
R2 has that too.
I mean, what? Well, I'm trying to think of what else I would like to put in there. Is it? I mean,
jammer. So when I they do kind of want to put one, jammer. You punish in there. Them.
Yeah, I don't necessarily know that I like the jammer if you're trying to keep incognito up.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's because more of you get a, range one first.
It's more of a, did they run to range one? Haha, now you can't order them to shoot me immediately. Now I run away.
Because yeah. I imagine you're going to kind of get these guys in the spot you want them to get. And then the way that I would immediately think to play them is just going to be observe standby every round. And that way, if anything gets within your incognito bubble, you can either A, shoot it first, or B, back away from it.
Do you like relay them in case they're at range for a command token and something else could get it?
I've thought about that if Maul is too far away from everybody else. Well, I mean, not only that. He's the jumping gap.
I could see it hit as a way to get a token to Maul. Yeah.
Well,
exactly. Except
the only Maul card that orders another unit, you just threw away to infiltrate them. So
this is true.
Maybe not. Yeah. I don't know that you use it.
You're going like to have R2's, other cards though.
R2's comm slot doesn't get used that often, even though the comm slot could be fun.
Rebels use something you kind of leave empty. More than clones do. Yeah,
yeah. It's a neat thing.
The thing that Brett brought to my attention first: there's no AI on them.
Nope, no AI.
They're smart boys.
Yep.
No, they are smarties. They're smarties. So
it's true.
Or they're just radio controlled.
I was going to say it's actually directly. The opposite. They're not. They're so dumb that they're just. They're just dumb enough to survive. It's great.
Yeah. So this gives me lots of hope for what the Observe token's going to do when we get the specialist packs here coming up.
Yeah.
Didn't one of the specialist models just look like a probe droid just by itself?
Yes.
And so you can maybe just add one to a unit and get Observe one?
Yep.
That seems pretty cool.
Hopefully
that would be the hope. And that, depending on point cost.
We'll see. But we also got three other cards spoiled in these packs. So,
yeah, we did.
To give me and Tim some stuff to talk about.
Yeah, that's right. Because some of us...
These OT boys aren't supposed to get stuff.
Oh.
I will say, I know this card's particularly good on Obi-Wan, but man, this card's really good in the old factions.
It is. It really is. Because that's Force Barrier.
Used it very well against me.
Yeah, we both use it well, honestly. But but Force Barrier, for those that don't know, because it's... I think one of the best cards in this the whole thing. Mm-hmm. But Force Bearer is when another friendly trooper, which is keyword here, another friendly trooper unit at range one is defending. Yourself. Right. Is defending against a ranged attack. During this modify attack dice step, cancel either one crit result or up to two hit results. And then you exhaust it. Or
they're just gone. Into the ether.
Which, that is so gross.
And remember, it's a force power, so anybody with Master of the Force, especially if it's like a supportive Jedi, looking at you, Palp, looking at you, Obi, can just bring it back. That's fine.
Did you know this card and Guardian 3 is really good?
Yeah. Keeping Royal Guards alive
turns out
slowly plod forward is going to be insane. Because you're going to get to parcel the damage either way.
So I've been playing Palp a lot before this card came out, and now that makes me feel good because I'm like, okay... Even if Palp doesn't get touched with any upcoming update, I can at least have a little bit more playability with him. Like, I can have him do... It's kind of weird, though, right? Like, normally you want wounds guardianed off of Palp. And in this case, he's... I mean, he doesn't take the wounds, but he's kind of taking the wounds through the Force. Like, he's the one guardianing for people. It's kind of the opposite of what you would normally do, but yeah. Again, I know you don't take the damage for it, but still. Just goes away.
So the only place that I plan this puts Commander Luke back on the table for me. I don't know that I put this on Op Luke because I kind of need his 200 points to run away from my army and cannonball.
Yeah, he's aggressive. Yeah.
But this to sit back and hit stay with your army and hide and like move refresh, getting reflexes or push and barrier up to support your army seems real real good.
Well, and like I said, playing Palp Bosk, super great with Bosk, because the best kind of white save you have to roll for is one you don't have to roll for. There you go. Boom.
Yeah, exactly. Taking
out the equation. That's absolutely the truth.
Even better, in my opinion, is Iden, who can already pretty much dodge decently well, but she still doesn't surge, so she can blank out sometimes. Let's take that out of the equation. So Palp Iden, there you go. Palp Iden, he's taking some of that damage off her.
I think this is great against Tim.
Oh, I think I could see a place for Vader. I think this helps part of his problem with other units.
Yeah, I'm coming at it, I guess, more from the angle that he's slower, so he's with your army more frequently. you know, as someone who plays Rebels, who Luke just kind of tends to run away, he tends, because of his nature of being slow as your troopers run up to grab objectives. And plus, you can do funny things with Implacable on this card, since Master of the Force triggers at the end of your activation. Vader can actually hit twice in a round.
Yeah. Gross.
So, but when Will throws 10 dice, gets 9 hits, and then cover takes away 2, so now I'm down to 7. I use this card, I'm down 2 more. It's only 5 I have to roll against.
That's manageable. Yeah. That's totally manageable.
Or when Tim shoots my phase 2 unit, Obi-Wan cancels 2 with barrier, then takes 2 hits and a crit with situational. Well, no, he can't. So he took 2 hits away and dodged them both away, so he just got rid of 4.
Yep.
And then sure heavy did. Cover took 2 more away, and there was nothing.
Yep. And then
magic.
It's evil magic. Yes.
I want to pause and I want to go back in the Wayback Machine for a second.
Oh, gosh.
A long time ago, Ryan used Han Solo and Esteemed Leader and Guardian like everything away, and then Han Solo magic cloaked like 9 other hits. Mm-hmm. And Will was like, I think I'm leaving this game now.
You mean like 2 years ago?
Yes, it was 2 years ago.
Yes.
And like I said, I was going to the Wayback Machine. I went way back.
Okay.
I'm just. We're but in the now, hot tub time machine. Now the shoe is on the other foot. You know, I don't know why there's a shoe in the hot tub time machine.
I'm eating
one.
That shoe as a delicious sandwich. It is delicious.
It is so delicious.
Not delicious maybe, for all of us, but yes.
Yeah. Maybe you
it's delicious
you,
for me.
You now, seize
for me,
the
I
shoe.
Have to put it on Maul. Damn or I have to put it on Dooku. So
no one's seizing the shoe. Shut up.
No one is seizing the shoe.
Trying to move us forward.
Try again later.
No one
later.
Is carpe the shoe. No one is carpe the shoe.
Shake the 8 ball. Try again later.
But I do kind of like it on Maul as well, especially if I want to protect my boys who are next to me. I don't think I would, honestly, put it on Maul. No, but it's a, no.
It's like how it comes in Anakin's pack and he doesn't take it either.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, honestly.
Maybe? Dooku has Master Dooku. 2, right?
Yeah, Dooku definitely.
Yeah, Dooku could use it because he's a slow old man.
I don't have any more points to spend.
But you could use it to keep Grievous alive in your double commander list.
No, oh, God, that would be delightful.
No, you use it to keep Maul alive.
Yeah, that's honestly, that's, you use to keep Maul alive.
Doesn't Grievous get 8 attack dice if he uses both lightsabers?
Yes, he does.
And they're better dice, kind of?
No, it's 2 red, 4 black, 2 white.
That's kind of better.
Yeah. Black dice and sometimes black dice. But yeah, I mean, but yeah, I know in a double fall list. No, this is absolutely a thing you can do is have him protect up, and if you put a steamed on him, you know, kind of keep him alive, Dooku. Right. Yeah, that could be very gross when both of those guys hit at the same time.
Yep.
I would just be honest with you, Internet. I'm not good enough to pull that off at the moment. I don't have enough play time, and I have enough practice time. But you know, one day maybe. I love the idea of it though. I do. Which is why I hate to say this. I kind of hate the idea of this next card. I get it. I know why. I just hate it.
I love this card.
I knew you would because you play nothing but these types of characters.
This is a huge card, though. Like, I don't think this is getting built enough. Like, this is
no, it's really
this is a
not.
Huge card.
It's getting overshadowed.
It is.
Yeah. Seize the Initiatavo. It's a that's discardable not
what
it card.
Wait, that's not. But I'm just
wait a minute.
You went to a different language.
You can't just make up words. You're the last person that should make up words.
I make up all the words.
Yes, you do.
It goes to
Yizgivitsk.
It's a training slot. It's only 5 measly points. It is discardable. Commander or operative only. You may discard it during the issue order step of the command phase to issue an order to yourself.
Seize my initiative harder, Daddy.
Nope, joke didn't work on paper. So, joke didn't work in practice either.
I laughed at it.
Yeah, I hear you.
I laughed.
Okay, fair enough. Just me.
And I know why we're going to hate this. I know why I'm going to hate this. I know why I'm going to hate this. Because I have a grand total of, right now, only 3 of those things.
Mm-hmm. And one of them in your list.
Like I said, 2 operatives now. I mean, but yeah. I'm going to have 1 of them. And I don't have that many training slots to spare. 5 points seems really cheap to get an order token.
But it really does. I don't know. It's 1 order token versus something like
it's 1 HQ time. But in a 6-round game, that's really handy.
Oh, it is.
I don't. Ben, put the alarm bells away. I think it is a good card, but I don't think it is an alarming card. I think it is right where it should be. It's going to be good for the people that use this kind of thing, which is Ryan.
Which is yeah, because if you
and maybe. Maybe the R2, not R2, but our R2 two units that just got double training.
Yeah.
No, I do like it. I do. Getting more order tokens is going to help the game balance a little bit. It's going to help some of the bad bag. We've all complained about bad bag. You know, it just gets you.
Rebels have bad bag syndrome.
They do. They do. So
yeah, and so when you take an operative, and you know, I'll use Sabine as an example. You have three cards that either just order them or all of our operative cards, and I'm mainly looking at this card for operatives, tend to order just them, and they can get lost in the bag on some of your other turns, especially as rebels, because our tokens have to go into strange places for some of our effects.
Weird places.
This card, just for pulling Sabine out of a bag when it wasn't her turn to play a card, and I had to play somebody Cassian. Else's one or two pip. Yeah. Just so I know that I can follow my 1-2 punch up with a Darksaber or with a Cassian sniper shot after somebody disengages or something is going to be like, that is worth its 5 points in gold. It's incredible. And I don't know how many times
it's definitely for you.
This card. Yeah.
I mean, the card has Jin murdering a poor civil servant right on the cover. So, right? I mean,
he was doing his duty.
Did you become Tim? Like, was this a Freaky Friday thing that happened? Like,
he was 5 days away from retirement.
He was in the reserves.
No.
He was just a natural disaster farmer.
I'm excited for this card.
Yeah, for you, this is a fantastic card. And the question is, when does it come out in a box you're going to buy?
Yeah, I know. That's the problem.
Hey, when I buy two Anakins to build both models, I'll give one to not Ryan.
Because I'm gonna need four copies of it.
Yeah, that's true. You're just going to need a photocopier then.
Yeah. I mean, luckily on the casual play nights, you can just do what these two yahoos did last night. Which is just play,
We wanted to have content about the card.
That's right.
That's what you claimed.
No, I've heard some other folks talking about different ideas for it. I think it was might have been Fifth Trooper talking about. I genuinely forget who was talking about. Well, one of the other casts
did they talk about Legion?
I'm giving full credit. Sorry. Okay. The Scoundrels, which is part of the Fifth Trooper Network, but anyway, the Scoundrels was talking about. I believe talking about like how like cartel. You put this on with Krennic,
and but it's Scoundrels sounds like the things. Parents in a Peanuts short.
Oh my god! You put this on with Krennic, and it can start giving you some interesting options, because if you play Vader Krennic with Op Vader, and you put this on Op Vader, and then you play Krennic's one pip, you can guarantee that Vader gets to go first anyway on that.
I just heard 17 ifs.
Yeah.
No.
I mean, yeah. And you put a binocular on Krennic in this card? I can't
judging
hold
that, would that be would occur.
Yeah, so much judging. With the eyes, probably with my body motion as well.
Like you weren't here last week when we mocked you that you were going to put binoculars on, what's his sideburns?
Callus. Yes, but you see, I actually do listen, so.
Yeah. Oh, that's right. You listen to our episodes unlike Ryan.
That's right.
I'm here every week.
But that's
also true. It's called QA. Never mind. Don't worry about it.
So I got to ask Tim. So you put it on Krennic to do that thing operative.
That I don't put it on the Krennic, Vader. I put it on the Vader.
I know it was confusing.
Yeah.
Okay. You put it on
there
Vader.
There were 12
okay.
steps.
Okay.
I'm sorry, we can't all just share whatever we want to share and just do whatever we please and then pay 35
really
points
easy,
to win the game. 35 points to win the game, everyone.
I paid 50 and it was still worth it.
Yeah, you pay 50 because you're a bitch. Anyway, what is your point, Ben?
So basically what I'm trying to ask is, yes. Do you use this anywhere else in your army? Is there any other place that you would put this? I don't see you putting this on Boss.
I think there's put it on Boss. I think there's lots of interesting places. Full disclosure, I don't know where it's going to be best yet.
Full disclosure.
I'm just saying, I think there's a lot of interesting placements for it. I don't know what would work and what wouldn't work. I think the big thing to keep in consideration is that it is exhaustible. So like once you use it, it's gone. Like, poop. I shouldn't say exhaustible, but discarded.
It's discardable.
Just
yep.
gone. Yeah, it's just gone.
But at the end of the day, you probably only need it once. Because
if it's
a commander or operative, they're coming with three command cards. Almost all of their cards are going to order themselves. And so you're getting four. You're pretty much guaranteeing that they'll have a face-up order token four out of maybe six turns.
So
Should it be a unique card?
No.
No.
I don't know if I would like it if all of Ryan's heroes have this card.
They all see. But
look,
initiative
look
at the
what
time.
I'm giving. Look what I'm. You got to think about the opportunity cost. What am I giving
but
up?
But he's the victim.
Killer. Will, there's you some forget. Yeah, that's true. There's some killer training slots that you're having to give up for an order token. You're having to give up an endurance or a tenacity or an offensive push or a situational awareness.
Or an essay.
But
for
we
two
just
points.
Talked about how this is the one thing you like need because the bag is what screws you over a lot of the time.
I do, but it means that why I'm solving that one problem, I am creating a bit of a deficit somewhere else.
I mean, I'm glad it has some opportunity cost, and I guess that
yeah,
it was just an yeah. idea. I think it needs to be. It was just yeah. like a should
I think
it be?
It'll be
probably not.
It'll be interesting to see how it pops up and how it plays out. I definitely think Rebels like it the most, but yeah. I think every faction can probably benefit from it in some way. Maybe not so much CIS, but I think most factions can benefit. Yeah.
Oh, I think CIS is definitely going to make use of it. I think Cad Bane, yeah, because he's going to be Cad out Bane's away from it. Everybody.
Well. Yeah,
but you know who else is going to take advantage of this?
That's also true.
Who Ooh, I'm afraid of this is on Padme.
Yeah, that's totally
because
fair.
so much of the time she's not necessarily getting the prime suspect for an order token because you're wanting to do
yep.
other clone shenanigans, but being able to make sure that quick thinking gets out when yeah. you need it to be. Or yep. because if she's going to issue herself an order, she can just give it to anyone she wants.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a gross
yeah,
idea.
That's yeah, that's a gross thing. Yeah,
so
exactly.
If you want to
try I was the with you guys and until he did that, and now I'm out again. Nope. Clones to Linda Esther. Yeah, right, let's just nuke him from the...
Back to Latin this time, I see.
Yes. I mean, yep, just going to go back to... Yeah. So I had not even thought about that, Ryan.
Yeah.
Now,
yeah.
So speaking of training...
This card's crazy good.
Speaking of interesting training options... We have the last two interesting cards that are in this pack, which is, of course, Offensive Stance and Defensive Stance, which, despite having Force users on them, are not Force powers. They are trainings.
Well,
however, you can only spend it with a Force user. So
yeah, Grievous can't take it.
Yeah, interesting balance there.
Screw that guy.
And I have one unit that can take it.
So Offensive Stance... At the start of activation, you can flip this card. You may flip this card, of course, so you have the option. You may flip this card. When you perform an aim to action, you gain 2 aim tokens instead of 1. You cannot spend dodge tokens. And then the flip side of it is, at the start of your activation, you may flip this card. When Wow. you perform a dodge token, or a dodge action, rather, you get 2 dodge tokens instead of 1. You cannot spend aim tokens. So it does the same thing, just aims or dodges, depending on how you do it.
See,
it should
on the
be
flip
noted,
side...
Well, and it should be noted that you don't have to flip it to do the ability. So you can
yeah, it's
finagle
always
it.
On while it's up.
Right. You can finagle it how you want. So you don't have to like just constantly flipping back and forth unless you want to.
Right.
You might want
it's
to.
Not
but
a, it's not choice. A when you flip this card, you
right.
do the thing.
Exactly. Right. It is a separate paragraph.
So defensive stance is pretty good on Obi-Wan if
yeah.
you're taking not reflexes.
Yeah.
I think we
Yeah. Yeah,
we
talked
about it earlier.
Yeah.
But
I don't hate it on Anakin either, honestly, to get some of those neat abilities. I don't think stapled, but it's neat.
I kind of do because in order to do his mastery, you need to be spending dodge tokens, which means you're not ever going to be in offensive stance. He tends to take suppression, so I think he's going to be a little action limited at points because his command cards can give him so many suppressions.
Fair.
And
that's
he doesn't
fair.
Need
yeah.
aim tokens
yeah,
because he's
I don't
rolling
think he takes
5 red dice.
This.
Yeah, that's fair. And remember, it does not, for those that might be wondering at home without looking at it, it does not trigger off of force reflexes.
Right.
It is
you
the
action. You have
actions.
To take the
it
action
in,
itself.
Yes, the action.
Now,
so
wouldn't it be cool if there was someone who had a mastery that wasn't predicated on dodge tokens that throwed some garbage... white dice
but got extra actions
and got an extra action maybe
So that would be me. Really well.
I hope this card doesn't come in your box.
Ben raises his filthy hand. And
I do. 5 points to get myself extra aims for those things where I really like. I like it. I absolutely love it and adore it. And if I need to be defensive for some reason, I can flip it over, take that dodge,
get two of those, and keep running. Problem.
Yes. 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 Right. Maul has always been the problem. Droids Delenda Est. He's not a droid.
He has droid friends.
He does have droid friends. Lots of droid friends. He becomes partially droid. You know. I absolutely no. I love this card. For 5 points and the flexibility in it, you choose what you want. It's rare that you're going, unless you're a clone player, have the aim and the dodge token at the same time because you know Padme gave it to you. So. Yeah, I absolutely love that thing. I do. This card's going to be great. I think great for Maul.
Yeah, I think it's a really interesting card for honestly everyone that has a Force user that like fits these criteria. Like it's a interesting, and also the other thing too is moving ahead,
but
like moving forward, it's going to be really cool moving forward for anybody else because I'm sure these are not going to be the only few people that can use it. Like there's Ryan's going to get more people that can use it. I'm going to get people that can use it. Like
because right now everyone I've only got op new Luke. Things.
Can that can, that can could use Operator it. Use these?
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm not going to, but he could.
Yeah, it's. I knew it was a could.
Yeah,
but I will.
The heartbreak like for Rebels is Op Luke. Yeah, Op Luke can take it, but Op Luke only has one training slot, unlike Anakin or Maul.
Right.
I really want this on Commander Luke, who doesn't have a training slot.
Yeah. Yeah.
Who doesn't have Master of the Force, so I'm more likely to just take a dodge action. Yep. It hurts a little bit. I'm not gonna lie, it hurts a little bit because the one unit I really want it on, I can't take it on.
Yeah, but you'll get new cool stuff. I'm sure something. Maybe you know, Lando will have it. There you go. You'll be a Force.
Lando will have the Force icon. Yeah, you're right.
Yes.
And then General Leia with the Force icon.
Yes. We'll start getting you know Gungans with it, and Ben can get. Force sensitive Geonosians with minds.
It's usually that Ben starts to ramble when I end the show, but it's Tim this time, so we're just going to cut Tim off and end the show. So fine. Thanks everybody for listening, for spending your drive time, your paint time, whatever time you got with us. And I'm Ryan Slawski, reminding you to seize the initiative.
I'm Will Hine, reminding you that maybe one day I'll pull off the Obi-Wan hat trick of killing Anakin, Grievous, and Maul in one tournament. One day.
We'll give you a special trophy for that one. And it's just going to be called Our Hatred. The trophy is just going to say, we hate you.
Yeah. It's going to be a mountain of salt. And I will sit upon it as my throne. It's a
salt trophy.
I'm just going to hit you with that full container of salt. Like it's salt for my family.
We can go out in the parking lot and I will stand unflinching and let you hit me. But I will still bask in my self-righteousness.
You can't spend a dodge token on a barrel full of salt to the forehead.
No, I wouldn't. It'd be dishonor a brew.
I'm Tim Hanner reminding you that you know what's better than 6 snipers? 7. Snipers. It's not, though. It's not actually better.
Yeah, you still didn't win. I don't know if you said that, but he still lost.
35 points to win the game.
Yep, totally fair and honest and balanced.
And I'm Ben Fowler reminding you that there is hope, CIS players, for Maul is coming.
Woohoo! Maul's coming. I can't wait to watch him as I
good night, everybody.
Don't get to use it.
Have a good night, everyone.
Goodbye, everybody.
Anakin is coming for the children, too.
Oh, he is coming for the children. Yeah. There's also nightmares. There's nightmares in the future.
I've hit record. Look at that waveform fly. Like America's freedom.
Lord, won't you buy me a Mercedes Benz?
I'm counting us in 3, 2, 1. I was like, that was either so really good or so really bad.
Holy shit.
It was really bad. All right, try it again, boys. Let's try to hold it together now if we can. It'll be 45 minutes on this intro. Here
I'm barely holding my life together, not this podcast.
In 3, 2, 1.